Right, good morning, Bombay. Okay, I'll try and keep this short because you have a Hollywood blockbuster coming from Mr. Jeff. So, thanks for the great introduction. I'm Vijayaraghavan. People call me Vijay. My game clan name is VJ. Okay, I work for this company called Gameshastra as an associate art director. I've been working with this company for about close to 4 years now. To quickly take you through the session, I'll try and provide as much as insight as possible on what's happening on the Indian game development. We don't have a great track record of building a lot of games, but we have a lot of games coming over in the coming months. So we are one of the India's leading game services company. We are the only Indian company who is authorized by Microsoft, Nintendo and Sony. So we are authorized developers of all three major companies, and we create games on almost all major platforms. Our headquarters is in Hyderabad. That's where all our production happens. And we have our corporate offices in UK, US and Japan. And just some of the platforms, we cover almost all the platforms here. So we are also gearing up on platforms like PS3 and X360, creating games on these platforms as well. So this is our facility in Hyderabad. This is a 1,000-seater facility. We are close to 200 now, and we'll be growing, we'll be probably doubling in the coming months. At Gameshastra, we believe in open floor policy. For example, there's no cabins given to the leads or to the producers or the project managers. Everyone sits in the same floor. That's because game development as such is very collaborative. You have to access people all the time. So you can't go and lock yourself in a cabin and waiting for people to come and grab you. So we make sure that everyone sits in the same floor. And we have a full-fledged game library, fully stocked with all latest games. And we have a game lounge where we have all the consoles, so we play a lot of games, basically. Well, that's our cafeteria. All right, I'm sure gaming is fun. It's a lot of fun, yes. How many of you don't play games here? Let me ask you the... Don't play the games. That's some girls out there. All right, it makes sense, quite obvious, right? Solitaire is still fine, you know, it still falls under the category of a game. All right, how many of you are CS fans here, CS fanboys? Oh my god. So I think it's 1.6, right? All right, I'm sure you guys... Source, all right, great. How many Modern Warfare fanboys? All right. How many Crysis fanboys? So yes, gaming is fun. But do you think game development is fun? Yes? Yes, gaming is fun, yes. It is fun, but it just involves the following. You have to work in crazy work timings. You don't really get offs all the time. You have a lot of crunch times, which means you have to meet your deadlines, working over the weekends, trying to work 10-11 hour shifts. And you have to meet a lot of impossible deadlines. What not. So, enough of scaring. But they were all actually true, actually. So, you have to do all that to be in game development. But it's actually... it is a painful process. I mean, when you're making a full-fledged game, there's a lot of challenges that you face. But still, it's a pleasure to make a game. So, to quickly summarize, it's a very collaborative effort. You have to have a lot of teams, a lot of minds. You get crazy ideas from your colleagues. So, let's say if you're a game designer, you have to be prepared to take ideas from your colleagues. You just cannot say, boss, I'm the game designer, and I tell you, you do the game. You have to ensure that you take suggestions from the teams. This is where art and technology is getting fused. Mostly it's painstaking. Okay, this is new. The Indian game development scene is very new. I think the first console game, the first PS2 game was this game called Hanuman, developed by this company called Arona, now known as Immersive Games. So it took us a while to get into console games development. Of course, we were existing in PC games. We were doing a lot of outsourcing for big games like Project Gotham Racing, Forza. But talking about development, it's very new to India because this involves multiple domains. You have to have design teams, a great art team, a great technical team full of engineers, and of course you have to have the testing team. So it was really hard to gather such a talent in India, and we are very glad now that we are starting to do this. And let me go through this. Some of the major players in India, I'm sure they all exist now. FX Labs, Immersive, previously known as Arona. You have Dhruva, you have Trine Games, Jump Games, and of course, we exist. So these are the forms of development which happens now in India. We make quite a lot of PC online games. We have started making console games. We do a lot of handheld games also. There's one threat in India. Can you guess what threat? Wow. Video game piracy. Frank as possible. Because how many of you buy original games? Please don't lie here. How many of you buy games from the pirated market? That's a little sad considering that I belong to the industry, and it's very sad, of course, because it's quite obvious when you're working for an industry and the product that you make is getting pirated. It's very sad because you're putting a lot of effort in making a product, right? As an artist, you have to do a lot of great effort into a game, and you come to know that the game is getting pirated. The game has to retail for, let's say, 500 rupees, but it's getting retailed in Palika Bazaar for 50 rupees, which is very sad. The scene is changing now. I understand. Frankly speaking, when I was doing my college, I used to buy games for 50 rupees. So let me be very frank here. But the scene changed now, you know. Once you get into the industry, once you know about the industry, you start transforming yourself. So unfortunately, most of the PC games and console games are pirated in India. I believe PS3 is the only platform which is left untouched. So expensive retail games, I'm sure you know this. If you want to buy a 360 title or a PS3 title, you have to shell out at least 3,000 rupees, right? How many of you play Modern Warfare or whatever console games in your 360 PS3? That's quite less. So do you guys buy them? Like original games? Good, yeah. So expensive retail games, you know, this is also the scene in the US, UK markets. Games are considered to be a luxury from one side, but it's slowly getting transformed. But yeah, you can't help because these games are made with a lot of budgets. You wouldn't believe the amount of budgets they spend on a big game. We don't even spend that money in making a movie in India. So that's a lot of money. Millions and millions of dollars spent making a game. Publisher is not making a lot of money because it's retail business. Of course, he has a lot of other channels where the money is getting spread. Retailing is always expensive. So how do you beat this in India? Any idea? Yeah, price needs to come down, yes. So tap your gamer market in India. The advantage with our country is you have a lot of population, you have a lot of young crowd, a lot of gamers basically. So basically you have to converge this. So you have to make the prices affordable. And it sounds easy, but is it possible to make it as a reality? One good thing is, though a console like PS2 is sort of a dead breed in other countries, especially in the US, UK, it's having a lot of potential and market in India. I'm sure you guys play PS2 games. How many of you play PS2 games still? That's great. So PS2 is an affordable console now. So do you guys buy PS2 games, original games? All right, great. So I'm sure all thanks to Sony for their effort in reducing the prices of the games. You get most of these games retailing for about 499 rupees now in the market, which is great, I mean, which is affordable for a middle income group. So two games came out, I think, last year on the PS2. One was this game called Hanuman on Mythology. I'm sure that game also gained some controversies, which is good, you know, marketing. Like Rockstar, you know. So again, we did Desi Adda. Okay, the idea with this game was we wanted a traditional game, which is, which has the origins from India. Games which has been forgotten by the younger generations. So we were quite clear on targeting the casual gamers, the non-gamers. So this game was not targeted for the hardcore gamers. We knew that this game is gonna fail miserably if I'm targeting this game for hardcore gamers. A gamer who's playing Modern Warfare is not gonna play this yet. So we clearly know that. But the hard truth or the hard reality is the population of the so-called hardcore gamers. Okay, before I go there, how many of you play games for more than 5 hours a day? So a lot of hardcore gamers, which is good. So the so-called hardcore gamers, the population is very less. The biggest market is casual gamers. That's why a company like Nintendo was successful, because they were very clear in focusing the console towards casual gamers. So we thought, okay, let's have a game which is very casual, target towards non-gamers or casual gamers. So we wanted to have Kabaddi, but we didn't want to simulate the game. But yeah, give the essence of Kabaddi. We wanted a Dance Dance type or the Guitar Hero type beat matching game, a dance game. Of course, we wanted Kite Flying. So quick facts about the game. This is the first game from India on the PSP. Game was, of course, Hanuman. First game on the PSP from India, developed completely from scratch in India. First game to go with multiple languages. We had, I think we had 4 to 5 languages, including 3 to 4 South Indian languages. Indian content, pure Indian content first time.